A Change of Seasons is the first and actually the only EP by Dream Theater. The, you know, one of the most popular and celebrated progressive metal bands pretty much in history. They are still to this day, I believe, the biggest progressive metal bands ever. And I've reviewed some records by them, you know, the basically every 90s records by them. Octavarium, Black Clouds, maybe something else, but those are, yeah, and 6 Degrees of Inner Turbulence, which is a personal favorite of mine. Yeah, you know, I've reviewed a lot of Dream Theater records, and that is mainly because I love the band, and people that watch me love the band as well, so there we go. And this is a request about Rock Do, and there was actually another record, the debut album When Dream and Day Unite, which is requested by Eduardo AZ. He hasn't requested anything in a really long time, I believe since Metropolis 2, which was way back. And he actually requested Awake, I believe a few months ago when I reviewed that. And then he actually commented on his own comment. And can you review When Dream and Day Unite as well? That was, I believe, a few minutes or a few hours later, so I didn't read that. So I actually, you know, I was just bored and I was just, you know, scrolling through my comments. And I actually saw that comment, so I'm gonna do that album probably the next time, or, you know, after this one. You know, Eduardo probably doesn't give a shit by now, but I'm still gonna do that. So, you know, be prepared for the debut album. You know, most people don't like it, but I still kind of dig it, I guess. It's a jam and stuff. But today we're talking about A Change of Seasons, you know, 2 minutes in and not even talking about one track. Yeah, like I said, this is really the only album, EP by Dream Theater. And it is pretty impressive, you know, that Dream Theater can make an EP with an actual, you know, studio album length. This album is... Or this EP actually is 57 minutes and 30 seconds long, which is, it's a tremendous length, really. When you go to Awake, yeah, that's 70 minutes long. But if you actually go to Images and Words, I believe those are exactly the same length. Yeah, actually, the EP is longer than Images and Words, which is insane. Images and Words is 57 minutes and 4 seconds. And... A Change of Seasons is 57 minutes and 30 seconds. So this is pretty incredible to think, you know, that they would release an EP that is actually longer than an actual studio album of theirs. That is pretty insane if you would ask me. We only have 5 songs on here, and I actually have the jewel case on my bed laying, so... Well, yeah, we only have 5 tracks on here, but... But every track is just tremendous after the other one. Yeah, this is actually... I never understood the cover. I think the cover is strange. I do like... I do really love the blue background setting with, you know, the white sand and the cabin in the back, if you can see that, with the trees. I think that is really, you know, it makes me really calm, makes me really comfortable. However, I don't understand the kid that is, you know, playing with the sand with the fucking rose here. I never understood that, but I do like the background. Then we get, you know, the title track, which is just tremendous. Arguably my favorite Dream Theater song of all time. I mean, you have that iconic acoustic intro, which is just tremendous. And yeah, that is, I believe, the Crimson Sunrise, you know, when the sunrise, when the song starts off, that is a perfect metaphor, in my opinion. Yeah, then the song, you know, slowly builds and builds and, you know, towards the middle section where the song really picks up in pace. Where we actually get some, you know, really, how do you say that, rhythmic drums or something like that. We get drums that have a lot of rhythm, I'm gonna say it like that. And the keyboards on there are really catchy as well towards the middle section. And what I probably love most about the song is the middle section, which is just insane. You know, when the song goes on a breakdown and when James LeBrie, you know, sings, "And I don't need your sympathy to help me through the day." I just personally think that is such an epic line. And, you know, when he just says, just those final lines, just screams them, has that final vocal delivery. That is so epic. Then the song is, you know, quiet again with the beautiful acoustic guitar sounds, which is just beautiful, man. It really is. And then the song eventually picks up in pace again, you know, for the final ending, for the ending credits. A Change of Seasons, you know, is really a masterpiece. I'm talking about the song here. You can say that about the EP as well, but we will get to that. This is an epic opener. I do have to say that, you know, the title track is the best song of the album and arguably the best song of Dream Theater's entire career. It really is a masterpiece. Then we get Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding, which is an Elton John cover. I really love, you know, that Dream Theater can show that they are pop, really pop in a way. Sometimes they're really poppy, like on Another Day from Images and Words, on Surroundings from Images and Words. Just to name a few. And I really love, you know, that they can have a pop sensibility, that there can be progressive rock, you know, pay tribute to their elders, so to speak, you know, Genesis, King Crimson, Yes, Pink Floyd. And that, you know, they have their own metallic, that their own metallic selves, Dream Theater, you know, the progressive metal side of them. I personally think that they, you know, perfectly blended together with the Elton John cover. A Funeral for a Friend really shows their poppy side that really shows how progressive and how catchy they can really be for the radio. And Bleeding, Love Lies Bleeding, is a bit of a more heavy track. It picks up in pace a bit towards the ending of the song. I personally think that they really made this perfect, because Funeral for a Friend shows their softer side and Love Lies Bleeding shows their heavier side. Which I think they perfectly chose probably the most two perfect songs to cover Elton John with. So kudos for that. Then we get Perfect Strangers, which is from Deep Purple. And yeah, you know, I love Deep Purple, don't get me wrong, but I'm not a big fan of, you know, their post wine, not wine from my hand, but Come Taste the Band. I believe that was the last record in the 70s. And I do like that record, but I'm not a big fan of Perfect Strangers, and especially everything after that. That is just kind of meh, I think. But Perfect Strangers is still a really special album for the band, and it is just perfect for Dream Theater to cover, because it is so, the keyboards are so heavy on this track. It really shows, you know, that the new recruited member, Derek Serinian. We're gonna keep it at that. Derek Serinian. He plays keyboards on A Change of Seasons and Falling Into Infinity. And he plays them pretty good, I would say. He is a pretty talented guy. And he really, you know, shines on Perfect Stranger, which is just a, you know, keyboard heavy monster of a track. They really just show, Dream Theater just really shows, you know, that they can be heavy on A Change of Seasons with a lot of depth. They can be poppy on the Elton John covers, Funeral for a Friend and Love Lies Bleeding. And they show that they have, you know, great melody on A Perfect Stranger, which is just perfect. And then we get one of my favorite bands, probably, you know, not... Dream Theater still is top 10 for me, I would say, but... one of my favorite bands as well is Led Zeppelin, and they cover The Rover, Achilles' Last Stand, and the song remains the same. And I believe The Rover and Achilles' Last Stand come from Presence, which is, in my opinion, an underrated album by the band. And the song remains the same as, I believe, from House of the Holy, so... I love The Rover. I love that the song is a bit more instrumental in a way, and kind of catchy. You guys know that I'm a sucker for Achilles' Last Stand, you know, that opening riff. Do 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 I just really love, you know, that main riff in Achilles' Last Stand. And I think that Dream Theater covered it perfectly. Although I have to say I prefer the original, I still really love, you know, what Dream Theater did with it. And then we get the song Remains the Same, which once again shows the more poppy side of Dream Theater, which I actually really dig about the band. So I'm gonna give Dream Theater kudos for that. That is just another great cover. And then we get the big medley, and this is the epic closing song, 10 minutes and 32 seconds. We get In the Flesh from Pink Floyd, you know, that song from The Wall. And you know, it isn't that Dream Theater is gonna play every song that they're gonna cover here in its entirety. They just show off a little bit. In the Flesh, you know, great catchy hooks. You know that riff from In the Flesh, from The Wall. Yeah, I personally think that they really they perfectly imitate the song. It almost sounds like I'm listening to a Pink Floyd song with a more heavy undertone, so that is really lovely. Carry On, yeah, they actually, Wikipedia actually fucked it up. It says Carry On Wayward Son, but I believe it's Carry On My Wayward Son. I believe they spelled it wrong, but I also can be wrong about that. Yeah, this is of course the classic Kansas song, and I believe this is their most popular song. And when I hear, you know, Kansas with their most popular hit, I always think of, you know, the Guitar Hero South Park, you know, episode, when you hear that doo-doon. Yeah, it always reminds me of that, and it's, you know, it makes me warm, it makes me feel, you know, it's nostalgic, because, you know, I'm nostalgic for South Park. Really love the show, so it is great to see, you know, that they cover Kansas, because I always, you know, think about a scene when I hear Kansas and that song. You know, it's not really related to the song itself, but it always, you know, makes me happy to hear that, you know, and makes me think about that. It's a fun memory. Then we get Queen's Women and Rhapsody, and this is of course one of the most classic rock songs ever. Yeah, I don't really have to say anything about this, because they covered it pretty perfectly here. Although I believe that James LaBrie didn't sing on this, because well, yeah, I'm not pretty sure, but I believe his vocal cords were a bit messed up when he did something really fucked up to his voice. So he didn't sing all of the time here. Well, on The Chase of Seas, he was just great, man. But on the rest of the album, he was pretty, you know, great as well. But you're never gonna beat A Change of Seasons, you know. You're never gonna top that. But yeah, I mean, not any Dream Theater song does that. Even Metropolis, in my opinion. Which is a masterpiece, really. The entire Images record, I mean, come on now. Then we get Loving, Touching, Squeezing, which is a Journey cover. And I actually really dug this cover. It is really upbeat, it's really fast. And I'm not sure if the original is like this, you know, with Steve Perry and Neil Sean. I'm not sure if the original is like that, but I still really dig this cover. It is really upbeat, it's catchy, but it still is really complex, you know, like Dream Theater really is. And then we get Turn It On Again, the Genesis cover, which closed out the entire section. And Dream Theater shows off once again that they can be, you know, catchy, that they can be progressive in a way. And they, you know, they pay tribute to their grandfathers, really, you know, Genesis and the other bands that I mentioned. They really, you know, show off that they are influenced by those musicians, but they don't, you know, copy them in a way. They are still Dream Theater's original self, and they perfectly showcase that on Turn It On Again by Genesis, which I also love as well. I love Genesis, so it's one big love fest here, you know. Dream Theater, Genesis, Zeppelin, Floyd, Queen, all great bands, man. Kansas, Deep Purple, you know, Dream Theater knows what they're covering, man. Just great bands, great musicians all over. Yeah, overall this album is pretty much perfect. I don't really have to say anything about it. You know, personally, if I have to rank it, yeah, I mean, A Change of Seasons, come on now, that's my favorite song. The big medley is pretty epic. I love the Led Zeppelin cover, the Rover, Achilles' Last Stand. Perfect Strange, which is pretty catchy. The only song that I'm a bit mixed about is Funeral for a Friend and Love Lies Bleeding, which is an Elton John cover, but I'm mixed about Elton John, so there we go. You know, I do like the guy, but I haven't, you know, scoped him out entirely, so cannot, you know, say that I love the guy, so there we go. But even that cover was incredible, because the Dream Theater showed up their, you know, more poppy side. So this album is pretty much perfect. It's an EP actually, and yeah, if you know, I have to say I'm actually gonna grab the cover. I'm gonna grab my favorite EP of all time. Yeah, in my opinion, this is the best EP ever made. You know, the Alice in Chains, Jar of Flies. I personally think that this is the best EP ever made. I love this EP, just every song on it is so fucking fantastic. Not to say that this is every song on this EP is fantastic as well. Even Funeral for a Friend, A Love Lies Bleeding, which I really love, but it is just my least favorite track. But in my opinion, this EP, just listen to it, man. This is, in my opinion, the best EP ever made. But in my opinion, this is a close second. Maybe for you it is reversed, maybe you think this is a piece of shit, but I really love Jar of Flies, but A Change of Seasons for me is a close second. So I'm gonna give this, you know, EP a 10. It really is perfect. The title track is one of the best. It's one of the best Dream Theater songs ever made, so go check it out. I love both of these things. Jar of Flies a little bit more, but A Change of Seasons, like I said, still a close second. I hope you have enjoyed this album review / EP review. Dream Theater, they are a great band, one of my favorites. I'm gonna check out When Dream and Day Unites, you know, now. Although I'm not the biggest fan of their debut album because of... what was his name again? I can't remember the name. What was his name again? Fuck. I actually have to go to the page now to really, you know, search it out. Charlie Dominici, I didn't look it up, but I remembered it. Charlie Dominici is on the debut album, and I'm not the biggest fan of that debut album, but I'm still, you know, gonna listen to it now. It's requested by Eduardo AZ a really long time ago, but I, you know, saw it just now, so I'm gonna get, you know, onto that. So I hope you have enjoyed this this EP review / album review. Yeah, basically this is an album review, because it basically has the length of an album review. So thank you for watching this album review. I'm the Ominous Wave of Music. I'm gonna change the name because it sounds a bit, yeah, ridiculous. The Ominous Wave of Music. I'm gonna change that name, but for now, you know, I cannot change it because I've, you know, changed it too many times. So you have to wait a few months, which is kind of annoying. But I hope you have to. I hope you have enjoyed this album review. Let me know what you think about A Change of Seasons, basically one of the best EPs ever made. Hope you have enjoyed it. Like, comment, subscribe to the Ominous Wave of Music for more content like this. Have a nice day. Hope you've enjoyed it, and take care.